Forget checking the weather on an app. Now you can step inside a portal and sample the weather from anywhere in the world. So Jeff, tell us about this. There's an airport in Stockholm that has debuted this.
Yes.
Climate portal, it's called.
How do you, with Vlad. Why would you want to do that?
Right? Yeah. I mean, why would you want to feel like you're in a thunderstorm?
Right. Well, that's the thing. It's not, you're not going to go in this closet and it's not just going to rain on you, which I thought when I first saw the story, I was like, oh, that's cool. It'll snow in this little room and I could go in there.
It just gets windy?
Well, there are. So there is some sort of wind element.
Oh.
But then I think it's just hot, cold, and, you know, lukewarm sort of room temperature, which is silly. But yeah, it's a gimmick for sure. They want people to be able to go into this virtual weather closet, is what I'm calling it.
And they have one in Stockholm's airport.
They do. It's this silver box you walk in and you say, hey, I'm going to, you know, wherever. And it'll say, okay, Jeff, it's freezing there. Now you're going to be freezing.
I can imagine if you live, for example, in a part of the world where it's always hot, below the equator or something, and you've never felt what it's like to be truly cold, like a Chicago winter or something, and you want to experience that. But I'm sure also that these things won't exist below the equator.
Right.
I don't see it in Papua New Guinea anytime soon.
It's very strange. What I can't wrap my head around is, like, why would they put, is that like a gimmick to get people to come to the airport?
Right. It's this odd place to put it. You would put it like in the travel person's office or something, right?
If
like,
those even exist anymore, right? So it's a strange sort of thing.
Right.
But their way of thinking is,
get,
you know,
people ready for the trip.
Yeah, like, oh, you just felt what it's like to be in Chicago. Go get a sweater before you get on the plane.
Because
it's going to be freezing in Chicago.
Right. Okay.
All right.
Or you can just check the weather, too.
Or you could look at your phone in 3 seconds
a lot
and not have to experience it firsthand.
All right. Jeff Bacalar, thank you so much.
Of course.